You have the violin? You've done it! Oh, my goodness gracious! Seems like you've been gone forever. Please tell me you have good news. Oh, my goodness! I must see it, please! Oh, my! It's more beautiful than I could have ever imagined. I can't thank you enough. I wish I had something to give you, a more suitable reward for all your efforts. All I can give you is the frequency to my radio set. Tune in whenever you feel like listening to the strains of an old woman's violin playing. You're a sight for these old eyes. Much better lately, thanks for asking. With the return of the Swa Stradivarius, everything has changed. It's like a long-lost family member has come home. Oh, don't be silly. I record everything I play on the nice machines built into my husband's old radio gear. That way you can hear the music anytime you want, and this old woman can get some well-needed beauty sleep. I would love to play for you. Sit down a spell and relax. My word! You actually found some real music paper. I didn't even think it possible. Yet, here it is. You've really outdone yourself this time. I knew getting the Stradivarius was a challenge, but this is just incredible. This is all too much. You deserve more than just a pat on the back. I'm speechless. Thank you. You're welcome here anytime. Consider my house as a safe haven if you're ever in the area. Now, let me get writing. So much to do. You're a sight for these old eyes. Watch yourself out there. The wasteland is no place to be messing around. Watch it, will you?
Hey there. I guess I can spare a few things. Another satisfied customer.
Yeah, see you.
Outsider, you have arrived. Please, come closer. I have something of the utmost urgency to speak to you about. Do hurry. He doesn't like to be kept waiting. I'm so glad you're here. It's been a while since anyone's visited us, and he's been waiting for someone like yourself to arrive. If you wouldn't mind following me, I'll bring you right to him. I'm sorry. In my excitement, I got ahead of myself. I'm Tree Father Birch, and I have the great fortune of being leader of his people, the Tree Minders. Beyond that gate is our home, Oasis. Yes, we're the Tree Minders. We're his people. If you'll just follow me inside, to the pavilion, all will be explained. Excellent. Please, follow me. All will be explained soon. We will speak once we've arrived in the pavilion.
Welcome, outsider.
Not to worry. All will be explained. We will speak once we've arrived in the pavilion. Not to worry. All will be explained.
You are welcome amongst us, outsider.
We're very pleased to see you, outsider. Welcome.
Welcome to Oasis, outsider. We hope you'll find peace among us.
Rejoice.
Rejoice.
The Great One wishes to see you.
You have no idea how overjoyed I am to see you. Normally, outsiders are forbidden inside Oasis, but he has made an exception. No, I suppose you haven't. In fact, few who live outside of Oasis have. Everything you see around you, from the tallest tree to the smallest blade of grass, is a gift from him. He is the one who grows. He is the one who gives, and he is the one who guides. No one speaks his name out of reverence for his majesty. Thanks to him, the tree minders have a home. We care for this place and keep it safe from those who would seek to exploit it. He gives to us, so we give back to him. It's an arrangement that's worked well for almost two decades. We shun technology and embrace nature. That's the life of a tree minder. Sadly, the wasteland is a hostile place, and sometimes we're forced to defend ourselves against it. If that means fighting with manufactured weapons, then so be it. Had he not asked to see you, you never would have gotten this close to the gates. Yes, my apologies. I don't speak to outsiders very often, and I tend to get lost in conversation. As you approached Oasis, he said you were coming, and I was sent out to meet you personally with a request. He wishes to meet with you. You'd be the first outsider to do so in a very long time. Yes, person. To meet him, you must undergo the ceremony of purification. Once that's complete, you'll be able to speak to him. Whenever you're ready, we may begin. It's simple, really. You drink the sap from the basin here in the pavilion. The sap will purify your mind and body of anything harmful that could possibly hurt him. I assure you, nothing harmful will happen to you. Very good. Take your place in front of the basin and let's begin.
Prepare yourself to meet him, outsider. It will change your life.
The air smells. Dangerous.
We will now recite the blessing to ward off any harm the outsider may be carrying before he proceeds to the grove.
I bid you depart. Agents of destruction, through the power of his divine will.
Leave our homes and bodies immediately. Live no longer in them, but pass over into places where you can harm no one.
In the name of his frondescence, I call his wrath upon you, so that wherever you may go, you bear it with you.
And, diminishing from day to day, you may disappear, except where you serve the health and good purposes of mankind. May no trace of you be found.
All this, may he be so good as to grant us, who is to come to judge the living and the dead, and the world by his verdure.
Amen. Soon, you will pass peacefully into sleep, outsider. And when you awake, you will witness his glory firsthand.
Glad to see you're finally awake. I can't believe they made you do that stupid ceremony. They listen when I talk, but they don't hear. You know what I mean? Neither have I. Well, I mean, I talked to Herbert, but he never really says anything back. Do you, Herbert? He kept growing around me. Maybe for calling him Herbert all the time. His name's really Bob. I think it's funny when I call him Herbert, though. Well, I suppose you could look at it that way. See, Bob used to ride around on top of my head. Sunk his roots in, right in there, you know? Well, eventually, he got bigger than me, and then I pretty much ended up inside. It was a long time ago. I tend to lose track. I was exploring some sort of a military base with some other people. I think it was called Mariposa. Mariposa. We were pretty deep inside and we found some weird vats of this nasty green goo. Right when we were about to leave, I think we were attacked. Yeah. Last thing I remember before blacking out was something knocking my friend into the stuff. You have no idea how glad I am to hear that. Or we're glad to hear that, me and Bob. I had you brought in here to ask a very simple favor. Would you please kill me? Oh, no, 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 no. It wouldn't be murder. You'd be doing me a favor. You see, I've been stuck here for over 2 decades now, rooted right into the ground. The only friends I've got are Bob and those weirdos out there who think I'm a god. Don't worry about them. When you decide to go down there, I'll have a little chat with Birch and the rest of the gang. They usually don't understand a word I say, but I'll make them come around. How to put this? I've been feeling rather spread out lately. I think Bob's kind of shoved my insides around some. It's hard to tell where everything is. But it's always that way with one's insides, isn't it? Anyway, I believe Bob's carried some of my organs into his root system. I want you to go underground and destroy my heart. exactly am I supposed to do that? I can barely move anymore. Thanks to Bob, I'm obviously not going to be doing anything for a very long time. You will? Oh, you made us so happy. Oh, isn't that right, Bob? Just give me a little time to say goodbye to good old Bob, and then I'll be ready. No. Herbert is the tree. Bob is his real name, but I call him Herbert because I think it's pretty funny. But I'm still in here too. What's left of me? The name's Harold.
And I'm telling you, you've got it all wrong. Why else would he have called for an outsider's assistance?
The outsider is here to deliver us from our enemies, to keep this place safely locked away from the wasteland, not to exploit us.
How can we preach about peace when all you want to do is keep his gift all to ourselves? That's not what he would want.
If we allow the spread of this miracle to continue, we're putting him in jeopardy. I can't allow that. I won't allow it.
Once again, my husband, we are at an impasse. I suggest we speak to the outsider.
Agreed. Why else would the outsider have been allowed into the grove? Perhaps it's a test. Yes, that must be it. I know why you're here, and despite what my wife thinks, I know you'll do what's best for Oasis. After all, he chose you, and he would never want to put us in harm's way. Oh, he's testing you now, just like he tested us. He wants to see if your faith is strong by spinning these incredible stories. Who else but a god could produce all of this? Don't worry, you'll soon see things as I do. Yes, I've been pondering that riddle myself for some time now, and I think I know what he's trying to tell us. The Great One's influence is growing, and soon it will break free of the confines of this secluded veil. We can't allow Oasis to call attention to itself like that. It would be the end of him. You misinterpret his words, my friend. He wants you to extinguish that which seeks to make him vulnerable. If the same sap that you drank to purify yourself could be applied to his heart, It should stop the spread. I can promise you no harm would come to him. That's all I ask of you, Outsider. Nothing more, nothing less.
I love Birch, but sometimes I think he doesn't see the big picture. The spreading of his influence is not a curse. It's a great miracle, a benefit meant for the entire wasteland. Of course we do. He yearns to share his miracles with the whole world, to give the gift of life back to the dead wasteland. It's upsetting him to no end, but Birch can't see the pain it's causing. But now that you're here, I have a feeling the winds are about to change. I heard what my husband wanted you to do. What I propose is an alternative. The same person that created the sap also created this liniment. If you can reach his heart, it will assist him in making his influence increase. Instead of centuries, the wasteland will become green in mere decades. Just imagine how glorious that would be.
Branch Tender Cypress at your service. Welcome to our little home. I wish they wouldn't argue so much. It makes everyone uncomfortable. Sure. Here you go. Good luck to you. I was an outsider like yourself, wandering the world aimlessly, wasting my life trying to seek my fortune. When my eyes beheld the splendor of Oasis, I knew I'd found a holy place. Tree Father Birch allowed me to stay, and I've been here ever since. Actually, you already did some of it. I had to do the ceremony and meet with the Great One. Then Tree Father Birch taught me everything I needed to know about Oasis and how it has to remain a secret. That's why I'm so worried. I just think letting this place spread into the wasteland would be an unwise decision. That would worry me. I was out there once, like you. I wandered the wasteland for many years. All I saw was poverty, famine, sickness, hate, and death everywhere I turned. But this place isn't anything like that. We can't allow that kind of evil inside Oasis. We just can't. Like I said before, thanks to Tree Father Birch, I learned everything I needed to know about Oasis and how it has to remain a secret. That's why I'm so worried. I just think letting this place spread into the wasteland would be an unwise decision. May your spirit rest in his branches.
Revel, Outsider. You are under his protection.
Yes. What can I do for you on this beautiful day?
I think this place would be lost if it weren't for them. There's no telling what fate may have befallen the Great One if someone like the Godless Raiders had gotten here first. He is the Great One, the Tree Father of Tree Fathers. There is no greater being in the world than he. I've dedicated my life to protecting this place from the outside world.
and I will never fail in that duty. I was brought here by his will. I heard his calling, and I followed. I believe only a few are worthy enough to find this place, and I'm honored to be among them. That's why I dread the day Oasis overgrows its boundaries. I suppose so, but you found it. How many others will stumble across Oasis? Will they be friendly? I'm worried, Outsider. I'm truly worried. I had to accept the ideals of Tree Father Birch and cast away my dependence on technology. May you remain under the canopy of his protection.
There's nowhere like this left in the world anymore.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Bloomseer Poplar, soothsayer and healer of Oasis. It brings me great honor to welcome you.
Lately, things have gotten a bit worse between them. It sometimes takes months for them to agree on things. I know they love each other greatly. But I'm afraid the strain of leadership is tearing them apart. Be wary of the water in the caves. I fear they still carry the sting of radiation from the bombs. In what we call the harvest month, the Great One creates seeds among his branches within seed pods. At the end of this time, the pods open and the seeds are carried quite easily upon the wind. It's quite beautiful. Wherever the seeds take purchase, they grow into trees, plants, grass, or all manner of wonderful things. He's not my god. He's everyone's god. You, me, everyone. This place isn't meant just for the tree minders. It's for all mankind. You'd think they'd realize that this place won't remain a secret forever. The caravans know about it, and you happened upon it. How long before someone comes to take this place by force? No, I say allow Oasis to grow, and that issue becomes moot. My father was a healer like myself. He had the most curious books I would read about trees and plants and their medicinal properties. Many years later, I heard a rumor about a place such as this. I spent a decade in search of it. I've been in this wonderful place for over 15 years now. I was the third one to arrive here in Oasis. Tree Father Birch was a bit wary at first, but Leaf Mother Laurel convinced him to let me stay.
If she hadn't been around, I doubt Birch would have ever let me stay here.
After a while, they taught me their ways, and together we developed the ceremony of purification that you undertook. Goodbye, Outsider.
Yes, what can I do for you on the...
There's nowhere like this left in the world anymore. Oh, Outsider?
There's nowhere like this left in the world anymore, eh, Outsider? So you're the Outsider, huh? You seem nice to me. They're the best parents ever. My parents told me never to go past the old gate. There are monsters in there. Oh, you mean Harold? He's really nice. Sometimes when I get really lonely, I go into the grove and talk to him. Sometimes I even curl up all cozy-like and sleep next to his root after I have a bad dream. I tell him what I'm scared of, and he tells me what he's scared of. It makes me feel better knowing I'm not the only one. Aw, I never knew an outsider could be scared of anything. Harold told me that he's scared of fire. If fire ever got on him, it would burn him and Bob until they were all gone. That's why we keep the fires far away from him. I was born here, silly. Just get born, I guess. You're funny. Goodbye, Outsider.
guess I was mistaken. I only killed so now I'm alive! I just come!
Here is done!